all your comments, it really pleased me to be here again. Thank you all for coming to the 20th Annual Washington International Trade Association Annual Awards Dinner, or we refer to it as the Trade Prom. In fact, our Twitter hashtag for tonight's evening is hashtag Trade Prom. If you tweet, I hope there's a lot of tweeters out there among you. If you tweet, I encourage you to use that hashtag. This year marks our 32nd anniversary. Since 1982, we've witnessed an incredible transformation in the trade world. Among the things the U.S. has negotiated more than a dozen free trade agreements, outlawed the WTO, and created a number of partner programs. Even now, we're engaged in negotiating trade agreements with four of our five largest trading partners. Since 1982, WIDA has also grown. Become an important trade policy institution in Washington, organizing meetings, trade programs, embassy events, and happy hours to bring together the Washington trade policy community. And a handful of dedicated trade policy professionals, we have steadily grown and now number about 1,800, with over 130 corporate sponsors. This is a WIDA membership all-time high. Every year we stage dozens of programs and events. The past year alone, we organize 22 programs, including 3 in Capitol Hill, all in Washington, D.C. So our reach is going global. We staged the first international intensive trade center in Guatemala in May. Last December, we helped organize a trade camp in Bali. We did one trade professional program during 5 years old. And we officially launched a new affiliate program, the Association of USPR Alumni, to recognize the contributions and promote networking of current and past employees with USPR. Just to see a shift, how many people out there are current or former employees of USPR? Hands up. I'm not raising my hand. All right, round of applause. While we stage many client programs, one of the things that then are this annual dinner, bringing the trade community together under one roof this year for their contributions and leadership in the international trade agenda. Tonight, we have a special debt of gratitude to many individuals who worked to put on tonight's dinner. Special thanks to Ted Ostell, the WITF Foundation President and our dinner chair, and Sarah Torrance, Bill Lane, and Ken Hutchinson, tonight's dinner committee. We'll give a special round of applause to each of us. Mr. Bill, you have your support. And a special thanks also to the entire WIDA board and the WITF board. Thanks also to tonight's volunteer team, and in particular, the WIDA interns who we have with us tonight, Catherine Tom from Northwestern University, and Hussein Rajani from the University of Georgia. And of course, nothing is possible without the tireless efforts of our team leader, Diego Inez, our program coordinator, and Javier Garrard, our executive director. Can you guys stand up for me? It's now my distinct honor to introduce our master of ceremonies for the evening. Peter Allgaier is no stranger to the trade community. We're the WIDA family. In fact, in 2004, we honored Peter at this dinner with the Distinguished Service Award. That I think was probably one of the funniest presentations we've heard. And this is the second year in a row that we've asked him to be our master of ceremonies. Please join me in welcoming Peter.
Is the presence of Louisiana Nuclear Senator Mike Moore here tonight.
Now, we're very grateful to all our sponsors, particularly our Platinum and Diamond sponsors, because their generosity is what makes it possible for us to enjoy this evening together. But there is a serious dimension to this event. As we reflect on the past year and honor those who have made significant contributions to international trade. Now, despite the frustration with the slow pace of many negotiations and the postponement of action on the Trade Promotion Authority, there really have been some noteworthy achievements this year in trade policy. And interestingly enough, including by countries that normally are not associated with free trade initiatives. So for example, there is the new Crimea-Russia Free Trade Zone, which set a world record for rapid implementation of such a comprehensive integration arrangement. Now, I don't know how many of you study Russia, but in the Russian language, they have the same word for into and by. And so when you talk about entry into force, it's the same as saying entry by force. I'm not sure the Ukrainians appreciated that linguistic anomaly. Another example is just this week, Brazil has unilaterally added a new services category to its GATS market access commitments. They did it in mode 4, which I think most of you know is temporary entry of foreigners. The categories are soccer coaches and goalies. So, we'll be talking about other trade advances later in the evening, but for now, enjoy your dinner, enjoy your table mates, and we will start again at about 7:48. Thank you very much.